2020. It's 2020, y'all.
Listen, it's 2020, and today I'm finna teach you how to get waves in 2020, okay? I know I told you guys last year, okay, in 2019, year before that, in 18, and 17, and so on and so forth, okay? But it ain't no difference, okay? We finna still teach you the same thing. We basically finna say the same thing, all right? But you guys will see the difference in what my ways look like now to what I look like then, all right? It's your boy 360 Jeezy. Come along for this ride, because it's a couple of stuff that I need to pick up from the store. So let's go. All right, you guys, we outside of Walmart right now. Finna go in there and pick up some 360 Wave products that I think is affordable for your average person. You know what I mean? When I first started out, I was basically using what I could get. And in Walmart, they basically got it all for a beginner starting kit. Let's go in there. Listen, I had to buy other things as well, okay? Chill. All right, so before I talk to you guys about waves and what waves are, let's just jump right into a better setting. How about that? All right, you guys, what you need to know about waves is that waves is basically curls laid down. Once you grow your hair out, your hair tends to curl, and all it is just laying down those curls. Now, when it comes to getting waves, all you do is brush to the point where your hair starts to curl. When it comes to my experience and what I know, I'm basically 7 years into really just being a hardcore waver, right? So all of this information that I'm telling you guys is basically built up information over time, right? This is not something that I researched and got information on. This is just something that comes from experience. So when you're trying to get waves, basically what the hair is doing is that if you ever grabbed a piece of hair, a piece of long hair, and you add tension to it and you pull, basically the curl starts to snag back and just kind of retract and curl. So that's basically what you're doing with your waves. All you're doing is brushing your hair, trying to get that same effect and getting your hair to curl up. So as a waver, one of the main essential products that you need is a hard brush, medium brush, and a soft brush, a do-rag, and some wave grease or oil. Now keep in mind, when I first started, I didn't go out and get all the expensive brushes, all the expensive greases and do-rags. I had to work with what I could afford. So I went out to Walmart, Walgreens, different places that was cheap to just start off my journey. You don't have to get all the expensive things right away. Now, what I can say is once you develop your waves and get your waves to a certain point where, you know, you want to upgrade. That's just like anything in life. You want to upgrade, you got the finances, then you want to start getting into your Torino Pros, your royalty products, you know, Poppy Blasteds, Goat Drip, even though that's a little expensive. We all know that's expensive, but at the end of the day, you're paying for the quality of the product and the name at the end of the day. So those are some products that you could get once you want to step your game up. Cause I kid you not, man, waves can really be expensive. But it ain't nothing like getting a new product to motivate you to brush and motivate you to just, you know, continue on your journey, because lack of motivation, lack of consistency, lack of drive and determination, that can kill off your waves and make you want to do something else. You know what I mean? So try venturing out and doing certain things with different methods, using different products. This all motivation for you to actually start brushing, because brushing is 100% key to this whole process. If you're not spending time brushing in the mirror, actually paying attention to what you're doing, then your waves are not gonna come out like you want it or like you see elite wavers. And it's best that you put in the time and effort, the consistency to get your waves to a point where you feel like they're good. Now, when it comes to the time you should spend brushing, I would at least spend an hour a day brushing. Now, this doesn't have to be a full hour of you just brushing. You could break it up in 15 minutes if you want.
Okay.
But if you're really gonna get dope waves, if you wanna get the waves that I have or anybody else your favorite waver has, you have to put in the time brushing. And about an hour a day is really minimal, but by this being a beginner's video, that's what it takes to get your waves to the next level. Now, as far as getting a haircut, and this is a whole nother side to waving, that you actually put your waves in the hands of someone else. So I recommend, if you can, start cutting your own hair. But if you can't, I understand that too. What I recommend is you go to a barber that actually cares about his craft as much as you care about your waves. When it comes to getting your first haircut, when you're getting waves and you're starting from scratch, you want to cut your hair low, all right? It doesn't matter, whatever is your low, because all different type of hair texture is different when it comes to guards. So whatever is low for your hair texture, you got to cut it all off, all right? And start from scratch. You got to brush until your hair reaches its curl length. For me, it's around a 2.5. That's when my hair starts curling. But anything under that, my hair is just going to be straight. So let's say you're growing your hair out to where, you know, it's pretty long. You see some ripples and you want to go get your first haircut. Now, usually we like to say wavelength. All right. You tell your barber to get it wavelength. For some, that's a 1.5. For straight hair, that could be a 2 or 3, or it just all depends on how straight your hair is. When it comes to what type of cut you should get, I always recommend when starting out, just get a lineup, just get all around. Cause what you want is you want your waves to develop all the way down to the hairline. You don't really want to jeopardize it with getting a taper or anything like that. When I first start, I just get the smallest taper right here, right? So I can have all the waves coming to the hairline. And you know, you don't want to really just get high tapers, because that really messes it up for your waves to come in on the sides. Now, when it comes to this term called woofing, woofing is a whole nother beast, all right? Now, woofing is basically growing your hair out to an extent where, you know, you're trying to better your connections. And when it comes to woofing, you gotta be putting in the work while woofing. You can't just brush your hair and then expect to just get waves by just growing your hair out. That's not how it works. You have to put in those hours that I was talking about, all while growing your hair out. Because if you don't do that, it's just gonna be lack thereof. You're gonna cut your hair off and notice that you're losing progress. Your waves are not as defined. So you have to put in work. This is hard work. Waves is extra, okay? That's extra. It's what the norm won't do, all right? Putting the time and effort into brushing your hair, it takes work. So if this is sounding too much for you, this might not be the hairstyle for you, because this hairstyle takes work. Once you grow your hair out, you've been putting in that work and you need to get a haircut, do not cut it too low, all right? Always keep your hair thick. That way you could go right back on your woof journey and continue to keep going. You know what I mean? That's how you're gonna better your connections. That's how you're gonna break forks and what have you. When it comes to methods, it's a lot of methods out there, all right? And some of those methods, all right? Some of those methods is just a pure waste of time. There's the hot towel method that I like to use. This basically, when you put that pomade in your hair and then you put the hot towel on, basically melting the grease into your hair, putting the do-rag on, going to sleep. That method right there is A1, all right? That's typical old school method, basically. What other method? There's a wash and style method. That one's a good method. There's a pomade method where you put the pomade directly into your crown and then brush it. There's all type of methods, man, out there, but you really gotta decipher from the ones that's good and the ones that's bad, all right? There's some out there that's just completely unnecessary, but there's definitely some out there that can help you on your journey. So as far as waving goes, it's really not that deep, man. It's more hard work than anything, all right? All the methods, at the end of the day, they cool and everything, but it's about the work you put in brushing, all right? It's about how much time you spend in the mirror paying attention to what you're doing. That's how you get dope waves. It's less about how much grease you're using. It's less about what is the silkiest do-rag. And it's not even about how expensive your brush is or how, you know what I mean? It has nothing to do with that. Some of the dopest wavers used a regular brush, a regular wave enforcer brush. So don't get wrapped up into what brush are you using or what grits are you using or what, you know, all of that is fine and dandy. But you have to work with what works good for your hair, all right? Everybody hair is different. Not everybody hair react the same to products. So find out what works for you and stick to it, man. It's consistency. So enough of me talking. Let's go and see what I'm working with as far as these waves, all right? Because what's up under here, all right? It's serious, okay? I don't play no games. All right, if you're new to the channel, hit the like button because what you're about to see is real, okay? And if it is real, go and hit that subscribe button while you're at it. Now when it comes to getting dope waves like these, it takes hard work, dedication, all right? Motivation, consistency, the will to keep going when the going gets tough and the tough gets going, you gotta go, all right? You gotta put in that work, all right? That's what it takes to have dope waves, man. All right, YouTube, this is how you get waves in 2020. And in 2020 and beyond, we putting in hard work, settling for nothing else. Waves is hard work, period. And if you add that to the rest of your life, if you add that type of grind, add that type of fire to your life, I'm telling you, you will succeed. Waves is a lifestyle. And when we talk about lifestyle, we mean really add it to your life and it will happen for you, all right? Anything that you want will happen for you. Your life is progress. Waves is progress, all right? Life is motivation. Life is consistency. So if you put that type of energy into your actual life, just imagine how your life will turn out, man. Waves is just subliminals, all right? If you put in the work, your life will be great. All right, it's your boy 360 Jeezy. If you like this video, make sure you hit the thumbs up. You're new to the channel. Hit that subscribe button, all right, with the whoa. All right, it's your boy 360 Jeezy. I'm out of here. Peace.